श्रुति स्मृति पुराणनामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं वादं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः सदाशिव समारंभं शंकराचार्यं तस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तं वंदे गुरुपरंपरां सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिः 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 यो ब्रह्माण विधातिपुरं वेदाश्च प्रणोति अस्मि तगुमहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः आं नयान्तिकं संसिद्धम् आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनमापूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे बाय द वे सतीश डू यू स्टिल हैव दैट क्वेश्चन ऑफ यस्टरडे Nityancha Nityancha. There is no Nityancha Nityancha in Chaitriya, I think. There is Niruktancha Aniruktancha, Satcha Tyacha, Nilayanancha Anilayanancha. Am I audible?
Yes, maybe I was not. I have some issue with my Bluetooth headset.
I see. Okay.
So for some reason, I had Nitya and Anitya in my mind. That's why you probably typed it out. Yes, you're right.
But anyway, the question is valid in the sense that there are opposing qualities.
My question was how do we read it vis-a-vis Jaina Mata interpretation on it cannot exist at the same time.
Yeah. So that is the thing. At the same time is the qualification there. So everything that is mentioned in the Taittiriya Srishti Prakriya. The prapancha has these tachcha, satcha, tyachcha. So all these pairs of opposites which are mentioned there, they are not simultaneously existing in prapancha. So they are not all padarthas having sat and being sat and tyat or nilayana, alinilayana, all these pairs which are shown, they are. What is said is that all these pairs, sentient, insentient, manifest, unmanifest, gross, subtle, whatever is you in the prapancha, all that has come from Paramatma, Parabrahma.
Yeah.
So they are not simultaneously having opposite qualities. They are
right,
not the same padarthas, they are different padarthas. And all those padarthas are basically appearance of Parabrahma.
Yes.
So that's what. And even if we say, I mean, how can there be manifestation of opposite qualities from Parabrahma? Then we say that it is Kalpita Srishti. It is Vivarta. It is not a Parinama. So thereby, as I mentioned in the last part, Advaitin can explain anything and everything with the Sattatraya. So
yes. That
is the basis that we have to hold on, because there are a lot of overlaps with many darshanas otherwise. So there are some even who are studying Bhashyas by themselves. They even have the opinion that the Bhashya refutes using some logic or some basis, which is also there in the Siddhanta. It is not true. For example, if you look at not only Bhashya in Siddhanta, so they say they have double standards. There are no double standards. You have to see the perspective. You have to see the satta in which it is refuted, or even in Tarka Sangraha. Not Tarka Sangraha, in Vedanta Paribhasha, you will see the contradiction which is apparent, and actually it is clearly writing on the wall. It seems like a contradiction if you do not understand what is that which is being negated in the Tarkika Mata. I'll give an example. It is very, very clear in Vedanta Paribhasha that there is a statement that Antakrana, Manaha is not an Indriya. In Vedanta Paribhasha, there is Vakya like that. Whereas for Tarkika, Manas is Indriya. So there is a refutation, there is a long an average discussion there, average length. There is a discussion, and then finally, the Siddhanti establishes that Antakkarana need not be an Indriya to be counted as the fifth. Manas Shashtani Indriyani. So there is this Gita Vakya which is quoted as Pramana by the Tarkika. How do you say that Antakkarana Manas is not an Indriya? Because Manas Shashtani Indriyani is mentioned there. So taking that Vakya in Vyakrana, in Vyakarana, the sixth need not mean the same, need not belong to the same species of the other five. The sixth is for Sankhya Purana. So Sankhya Purana does not mean six, it means sixth. So sixth is a count, and that count need not be of the same species. So although the Indriyas are five, still the Antakarana Manaha can become the sixth. So what it means is that in the series of five Indriyas, and where the Antakarana, which is a non-Indriya, is sixth, that also can bring about this statement in the Smriti. This is how it was established. Later the Siddhanti himself says that Antakarana is an Indriya. So the so much effort has been taken to refute the Tarkika's perspective as to Manas being Indriya. Siddhanti saying it is not an Indriya, and then Siddhanti says that it is an Indriya. The difference is that the Lakshan of Indriya should be considered. What is an Indriya? The Indriya for the Tarkika is different from Indriya for the Vedantin. Therefore, what has been refuted is that the Indriya of the type of Tarkikas, Antakarana, is not. So Antakarana is not the Indriya the way the Tarkika defines, and Antakarana is an Indriya the way the Vedantin defines. So this has to be very clear, and this can be understood only when one has studied in the Sampradaya and having asked questions, trying to inquire into it. Otherwise, on the face value, definitely there is a contradictory statement. In Shruti also you come across many such things. So it is all apparent contradiction. It can be resolved. Anyway, with that background, let's continue. With Nanu, Atmanah Savayatva Angikarat Kramena Pravesho Astritya Ashankya Ah. So the 35th Sutra has been introduced by the Vritti as Atmana Savayatva Angikarat. In the earlier sutra, what was said? Evan Chatma Karsnyam. If you say that the Atma has a Deha Parimana, has the size of the body, then this Atma, Jivatma, cannot enter the Gaja Sharira. Manushya Jivatma cannot enter the elephant's body completely, or cannot take up the ant's body at all, cannot enter the ant's body at all, being huge. In another Janma, if that is the karma, this was the refutation as to Atma having a size limited to the body, or size of the body, not limited, size of the body. Now the Purapakshi says Atma can be Savayava, meaning with parts. So if we accept that in our darshana, Jaina darshana, then Atmanah Savayatva Angikara Kramena Pravesha Astu Sharire Bhinna Bhinna Sharireshu. Although the Shariras have different size, and one might object as to the Atma, which is of the Manushya Sharira size, cannot enter the Gaja Sharira completely, there can be parts which are added. So Atma can have parts, and Kramena, slowly having entered, there will be more parts, and then it will grow up to the Gaja Sharira, or it will drop parts and enter the Ant Sharira, Puttika Sharira. How about this kind of a Darshana acceptance from Jaina's perspective? That would resolve this issue. Therefore, we will say that Atma is Savayava. This will resolve the earlier objection, earlier defect. There the Sutrakara responds saying, Nacha Paryayad Apyavirodho Vikaradibhyaha, Nacha Paryayad Apyavirodho Vikaradibhyaha. So Nacha Paryayad, Nacha Paryayad Apyavirodho Vikaradibhyaha. So Nacha Paryayad, if you take this option out of saying that the Atma's size will vary based on parts, so if you take that paryaya option, then even then, even from that, what happens? The virodha that we have shown, there will be no resolution to that. If you claim avirodha, that is nacha paryayad. So paryayad chapi avirodha na. There is no avirodha, meaning there will be virodha, still there will be virodha. What kind of a virodha will be there will be clear in the vritti, but the avirodha that you think as to what the manushya size atma cannot enter the gaja size sharira completely, or not even enter the ant sharira, that kind of a virodha will not be there. It appears so. However, what will happen is that vikaradibhya, because this savayava atma will be having vikara, so vikaradibhya doshebhya virodha asti. So you think that one virodha is gone, but the virodha will be there. There are many other virodhas which will be there. So darshana virodha will still be there. So you can make a basic vritti as to atmanaha cha avayava. Being savayi, what happens? Avayava gamana agamana abhyam paryayad api. So atmanascha. So because cha and api put together instead of the dedication, so atmanascha avayava gamana agamana. Because parts will be added and dropped, therefore avayava gamana agamana abhyam paryayadapi. What is that? Gaja puttikadi sharira praveshe avirodha, that is a claim. No, and we have pointed only one virodha with the gaja and puttika sharira examples. But this is not the only virodha. There are many other darshana virodha also possible. Therefore, vikaradibhya doshebhya. Vikaradibhya is a hetu. Doshebhya, which are doshas. Atma becoming vikari is a dosha. So, atmanaha vikaradibhya doshebhya yathasthiti. The Jaina system not being valid will still hold good as an objection from the Siddhanti's angle. So what is the detail there in the vritti? Paryayena api avayava gamana agamana abhyam, by parts being added and removed from the atma, what will happen is that tattat stula sukshma sharira parimanatvasya atmani avirodha iti. This is the Purvapakshi claiming as to tattat stula sukshma sharira parimanatvasya. Not only stula sharira, but sukshma sharira can also grow. Sukshma sharira, because you think that in the gaja sharira, the sukshma sharira cannot be of the size of the manushya. It should be having a large size. Otherwise, without the sukshma sharira being large enough as the stula sharira, there won't be any sensation throughout. The sensation of touch, you take a simple example of sensation of touch, that won't be possible if the antakkarana is not all pervasive in the body. Therefore, sukshma sharira can also have the stula sharira size. It has to be understood in this manner. Similarly, now this atma also, avayava gamana agamana, with the atma being savayavi, savayava. Avayavaihi sahavartati di savayava. Savayavaha atma. So the atma being savayava or avayavi. Avayavi atma or savayava are paryayavachi shabdas. So the atma having parts being dropped or added, it can grow to the size of the gaja sharira or become smaller enough to enter the puttika sharira. Whether it, both the sukshma and the stula sharira, it can enter. Therefore, atmani vishaya avirodha, the virodha which was pointed with respect to atma as to size cannot grow and lessen, that dosha won't be there. Therefore, avirodha iti chet nacha. No, it won't be so, says the Siddhanti. Why kutaha? विकारादिभ्यः दोषेभ्यः विकारादिदोषाद् विलक्रु आत्मनः सावयत्वेन तत्तत् शरीरप्राप्त्या वृद्धिह्रासत्व वृद्धिह्रासवत्व अंगीकारे विकारित्व प्रसक्त्या अनित्यत्वे बंधमोक्ष अभ्युपगमः बाध्येत इत्यर्थः. वॉट वुड हैपन इज दैट दी जैन दर्शन ऑल्सो एक्सेप्ट समथिंग कॉल्ड एज मोक्ष एंड मोक्ष इज फ्रॉम बंध सो एक्सेप्ट बंध ऑल्सो सो बंध एंड मोक्ष अभ्युपगम विच हैज बीन एक्सेप्टेड इन दी जैन दर्शन एंड ऑल्सो इन अदर दर्शन वेर बाय दी दर्शन एग्जिस्ट दी दर्शन रोल इज टू कनेक्ट दी साधक टू मोक्ष as to what is moksha, it has to explain what is bandha, how this bandha comes about, all that has to be explained, and then means to moksha has to be revealed, then the sadhaka is connected to the means, and then thereby through the means connected to the phala, sadhaka is led to the phala, which is moksha. Bandhat muktaha bhavet darshanena, with that darshana as a tool. Now this darshana which claims bandha moksha, that will be negated, badhyeta. Why? Vikaritva prasaktya. Atma being savayava, definitely there is vikara in the atma. If atma becomes vikari, then this vikari prasakti will be there, and through this vikari prasakti, if atma becomes vikari, then atma will become nitya, anitya. Nitya atma will become anitya. So vikaritva prasakti is hetu for anityatvam of atma, and anityatva is hetu for bandha moksha being badhita. In the darshana, bandha moksha will not be possible. This vyavastha itself will not be possible. Bandha will continue to be, there will be no moksha ityarthaha. Why? Because savayatvena you think that because atma is savayava, therefore tattat sharira praptya, tattat means gaja or puttika sharira, प्राप्ति विल बी देर इन डिफरेंट जन्माज एंड देर बाय वृद्धि ह्रासवत्व दि वृद्धिवत्व एंड ह्रासवत्व वृद्धि इज ग्रोइंग एंड ह्रास इज लेसनिंग सो देर बाय वॉट विल हैपन इज दैट दि आत्मा कैन एंटर देर इज अ typo here, it should be double takara here. So this should be double takara there. Vriddhivatva and Hrasavatva. Put together Vriddhihasavatva, itara itara dvandva and tayoho angikare. When you explain the atma having avayavas, then whenever there is a prapti of a larger sharira, then there will be vriddhi. In the Vriddhivatva, Atma has Vriddhivatva thereby. Whenever there is a prapti of a smaller sharira, smaller size sharira, then what will happen? There will be Hrasavatva in Atma. Atma will reduce in size. But when you are saying that parts are there, then you have to accept that there is change in Atma. So Vikaritva Prasakti is there. Such kind of a Prasanga. Prasakti is Prasanga. So Vikaritva prasanga will be there. Atma will become vikari. And if atma becomes vikari, atma will become anitya. If atma becomes anitya, then moksha won't be possible. This is the dosha. These are the doshas. So vikaradibhya doshebhya anityatva is a resultant. Kincha, moreover, what else is possible? What else is the resultant? अन्त्यावस्थितेश्चोभयनित्यत्वादविशेषः. सो सूत्रकार सेज अन्त्यावस्थितेः च उभयनित्यत्वात् अविशेषः. जी जैन दर्शन सेज दैट आत्मा हैज अ पर्टिकुलर साइज देह परिमाण. नाउ in their darshana, what do they say is the size of the atma when the sadhaka attains mukti. So in moksha avastha, antya avastha is the moksha avastha, antya, the last avastha. What is the last avastha for the jivatma? It is the antya avastha, which is moksha. So moksha avastha in the मोक्ष अवस्था ओट अंत्य अवस्थिति ही इज देर अंत्य अवस्थिते हे इज द हेतु हेतु पंचमी सो अंत्य अवस्थिते हे च सो ड्यू टू द अंत्य अवस्थि अंत्य अवस्थिति ड्यू टू द अंतिम अवस्थिति द लास्ट अवस्था ऑफ द jivatma in size what is the in moksha what is the size of the atma whatever is the size atma is nitya so what is the antya avasthiti avastha of the atma atma is nitya so atma is nitya now also for the siddhanti the darshanika jaina darshanika is asked what is the state of the atma at least in the moksha avastha Shouldn't it be nitya? If it is nitya, atma being nitya in the last state, it cannot have any change. So now if you say vikari, this vikaritva prasakti is there now, but in the moksha avastha, you say moksha is not possible, says the Purvapakshi to the Siddhanti. This kind of an objection is not valid because in the antya avasthiti, in moksha, the atma will remain avikari because there will be nityatvam and the size will be the same. In the last avastha, the size is same. It won't change. Then how is atma vikari? It is not vikari. What happens is the atma in the antya avasthiti is being nitya, it will have that parimana which is whatever is the parimana in the moksha avastha, the last janma, that will be the size of the atma. There is no change there. So thereby we can say vikaritva dosha can be taken away. This is a thinking that you can see underlying this sutra which is being refuted. So antya avasthite he, now the Siddhanti says, okay, in the antya avasthiti you are saying that atma is nitya, therefore in the moksha avastha whatever is the size of the atma, that will be the size of the atma. There won't be further change. If you say that and say nityatva is the hetu there, so you are saying antyavasthitehe, antyavasthitihi, or you say antyavasthitehe as a hetu, antyavasthitehe mokshavasthitescha atmanaha parimana nityatvam. You say that nityatva is the hetu, nityatvat atmanaha parimana nityatvam. आत्मना नित्यत्वात् आत्मना परिमाण नित्यत्वम् कदा होती कुत्र होती मोक्ष अवस्थायां सो इन मोक्ष अवस्था दिस इज द स्टेट देयरफॉर अंत्यावस्थितेः मोक्ष अवस्थायां और मोक्ष अवस्थितेः च आत्मना परिमाण नित्यत्वम् एंड यू कैन रीड हियर दिस नित्यत्व आत्मना नित्यत्वात् नाउ दिस आत्मा बीइंग नित्य सिद्धांति सेज उभय नित्यत्वात् अविशेषः This nityatva of atma in the antya avasthiti is not something which is vishesha, it is not something special. When you say nityatvam of atma, it should be nitya all the time. Nitya is not something which is agantuka nityatvam. There is no pravaha nityatvam. If you say pravaha nityatvam, it will become vikari. Maya has pravaha nityatvam in Siddhanta. Because people will say, what is nitya in Siddhanta? So many things are talked about as nitya in Tarkika's mata. We refute all of that. We say we do not accept this samavaya. We don't accept this nityatva of paramanu zityadi. But then they say, oh, you accept the nityatva of maya. We say maya has pravaha nityatvam. Across kalpas, maya itself is kalpita. And that kalpita maya has nityatvam, which is pravaha nityatvam. What is pravaha nityatvam? Like a flow. Ganga has a flow, Ganga, it's not the same water. So, if the water that you touch the second time when you dip your hand in Ganga, that water, if the second time the water is the same as the first time, then it is Nitya. But it is not the same. It's a different water, but it has an appearance of being same because there is a flow. There is no break. You don't see a set of water split with space and then some other set of water particles or quantity of water. So you don't see such kind of a thing happening there. So there is a continuous flow, and thereby there is pravaha nityatva of Ganga. Similarly, there is pravaha nityatva of Maya, because across kalpas there is a same continuity of Maya from the earlier kalpa. Similarly, prapancha also. Prapancha is anitya, but it also has pravaha nityatva across kalpas. This is different from the nityatvam, which is satyatvam, nityatvam, trikala, abhaditatvam, that is there only for Parabrahma Paramatma, who is non-different from Jivatma. Now, since the Jaina Darshana says that in the Antyavastha, the Parimana of the Jiva, Atma, is what? Is Nitya. Because Atma is Nitya, therefore this Jiva, or need not give a Hetu also. I am just saying we can read a Nityattvam Hetu of Atma, but that is not needed. Just the Nityattvam of Atma in the Antyavastha, that is sufficient for us to refute using this sutra. So we are saying, if at all Atma is Nitya in the Antyavastha, and therefore Atma Parimana is Nitya, the size of Atma is Nitya, and will thereby Atma will be changeless in the moksha state, we will say that Nityatva Hetu will pervade the other states also. What other states? The earlier two states also. Earlier Janma and the other Janma, meaning earlier Avastha and the changing Avastha before reaching the Moksha Avastha. So you read some earlier and Madhya, and thereby the Adhya and Madhyama Parimana also, meaning the smaller size and the larger size, whatever is the size, whether it is the whatever is the size of the, see, Mukti is possible only in Manushya Avastha. Therefore in Manushya Avastha, whatever is the size, Gaja Parimana is higher. We have already shown that the Atma will not be able to enter the Gaja Sharira, in which is what as the we can take as one Parimana, and the earlier Parimana is before he took the Gaja Sharira, or it can be Puttika Sharira also, any Sharira. So we read two different sizes from this Manushya. So you can see the larger size and the smaller size, or the Madhyama Parimana and the earlier Parimana. So whatever is the size in the earlier Janma and the next Janma, meaning all other Janmas before attaining the Moksha Avastha. Basically you can take any of these with the Ubhaya, Ubhaya Nityatva. So Ubhaya meaning Adhya and Madhyama Parimana will also become Nitya. Not only this, because in the Antyavastha, what will be the Jiva Parimana? You have to read a larger size. So they don't particularly describe that. So we may say that in the Mukti Avastha, the Sharira Bandhana is not there. So what is it? It is Nitya, all pervasive, whatever is the claim. Let's say the claim is that it will have the largest size, and then thereby it won't change anymore. This is what you have to see, because Atma cannot have limited size in Mukti Avastha. So therefore in Darshana we'll give them some concession and say Atma has that size which will not change anymore, and that size is a large size. Let's say limitless size or whatever we have in our own Shastra, we'll give that kind of a concession to them. And then we can read in Adhya and Madhyama Parimana, because otherwise Ubhaya Parimana, because the Vrittis is Adhya and Madhyama, so we have to say that the Antyavastha has a let's say a larger size. And what larger size? We will say the Vyapaka size, completely Vyapaka size. Then due to that, what will happen? Due to the Atma having Nitya Parimana in the Antyavastha, Moksha Avastha, therefore in the other avasthas, other avastha meaning baddha avastha, other avastha singular, in the other baddha avastha where the Atma keeps on taking various shariras, there the middle size and the smaller size, if you say Adhya and Madhyama Parimana, the Ubhaya Nityatvam will be the prasanga, because Parimana Nityatvam if you claim only in the Moksha avastha, that is Atma's size, therefore Atma is Nitya. And Atma being Nitya, Atma Parimana being Nitya, that Nityatva will not apply only to the Antyavastha, it will apply to the Madhyama and the Adhyavastha also. Thereby Ubhaya Nityatvad, मीनिंग आद्य एंड दी मध्यम परिमाण नित्यत्वात् तेषां त्रयाणां मध्ये अविशेषः अंत्यवस्था आत्मा मध्यम परिमाण आत्मा एंड दी आद्य परिमाण आत्मा ऑल ऑफ देम विल हैव नो विशेष वाय बिकॉज नित्यत्व इज कॉमन नित्यत्व हेतु इज कॉमन अक्रॉस दी थ्री देयरफॉर परिमाण नित्यत्वम विल लीड टू नो विशेष नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन दी मोक्ष अवस्था एंड दी अदर अवस्था बद्ध अवस्था इन बद्ध अवस्था आद्य एंड मध्य परिमाण विल कंटिन्यू एंड दैट विल मेक दी आत्मा ईदर यू से आत्मा इज विकारी वेयर बाय विकारादिभ्य दोषेभ्य अविरोध न और यू हैव टू से वॉट अविरोधो न और यू हैव टू से आत्मा इज नित्य आत्मा परिमाण इज नित्य एंड देयर फोर The Atma size is Nitya in all avasthas. If it is Nitya, then it cannot change size. Then the earlier doshas as to it cannot enter Gaja Sharira or it cannot enter the Puttika Sharira will hold good. So you cannot take one paksha and say all the doshas have gone. If you choose one paksha, then some doshas will go, other doshas will accrue and thereby the Jainas darshana cannot be seen to be Pramana Moola. वृत्ति से अंत्यस्य मोक्षावस्थाभाविनः जीवपरिमाणस्य नित्यत्वेन अवस्थितेः तत्पूर्वयोर् उभयोरपि आद्यमध्यमपरिमाणयोः नित्यत्वप्रसंगात् बिकॉज ऑफ नित्यत्व प्रसंग ऑफ दि आद्य एंड मध्यम परिमाण दि स्मॉलर एंड दि मिडिल साइज ऑल्सो मीडियम साइज ऑफ दि आत्मा विल ऑल्सो बिकम नित्यत्व नित्यत्व प्रसंग ऑफ दो साइजेस ऑल्सो एंड दीज आर रेंज ऑफ साइजेस आद्य एंड मध्यम परिमाणस अ रेंज ऑफ साइजेस वी कैन टेक ऑल ऑफ द बेसिकली ऑल साइजेस ऑफ आत्मा विल बिकम नित्य बिकॉज ऑल देह साइजेस आर द साइजेस ऑफ आत्मा एंड इन द एंड सडनली इट हैज बिकम चेंजलेस यू कैन हैव सडन चेंजलेसनेस नित्यत्व शुड बी सीन थ्रू एंड थ्रू और अनित्यत्व शुड बी सीन थ्रू एंड थ्रू वॉट इज अनित्य कैनॉट बिकम नित्य वॉट इज नित्य कैनॉट बिकम अनित्य देयरफॉर नित्यत्व नित्यत्वेन अवस्थिते Because this, in the moksha avastha, atma is nitya, atma parimana is nitya. Therefore, moksha avastha bhavinaha, atmanaha, jiva parimana siddhi, atma, jivatma parimana. The size of the jivatma in moksha avastha, which is present in moksha avastha, that is the antya avastha. Thereby, avasthite he, nityatvena, that avastha is nitya. मोक्ष अवस्था इज नित्य आत्मा इज नित्य बट फाइनली वॉट इज द क्लेम आत्म परिमाण इज नित्य द साइज ऑफ आत्मा इज नित्य इन मोक्ष अवस्था दैट इज द अंत्यावस्थिते हे अंत्यावस्थिते मीन्स द आत्मा साइज जीवात्मा साइज इन द आत्मा इन द मोक्ष अवस्था इज नित्य तत्पूर्वयर उभयरोपि बिफोर दिस मोक्ष अवस्था द अर्लियर टू साइजेस ऑफ द आत्मा आद्य एंड मध्यम परिमाण They will also become nitya, nityatva prasangat. What happens? Trayanam, adhya madhyama, antya parimananam, avisheshaha. So moksha is seen as antya parimana. Now it need not be larger size also. There is some, see, my issue is that adhya and madhyama, to me that is not needed. Because we say only adhya avastha, bandha avastha. But for some reason adhya and madhyama has been used. I tried to scout around, I couldn't find much meaning to separate or give, give additional meaning to Adhya and Madhya or make differences between these. Therefore, we can consider as some changes in the Jiva in the earlier Janma and the later Janma, but it has not been used. The word is not later, it is Madhyama. Adhya can be seen as earlier, but Madhyama is a little tricky to read. Make sense out of in the sense to differentiate between Adhya and Madhyama. So we can say some range of sizes can be taken in the earlier Janma or the middle Janmas. So thereby some kind of a meaning can be given. Basically what it means is that Adhya and Madhyama put together also we can say the range of sizes in the earlier Avastha. Whatever is the size of the Atma in various Janmas in the Baddha Avastha. So I read it as Baddha Avastha. Adhya Madhyama are both in Baddha Avastha. So whether we say Adhya Madhyama or range or whatever, one would have been sufficient in my understanding because I can't make much sense out of it. So I am unable to see more in that. So it is a flaw on my side. I should not say that the vritti is incorrect, but I cannot see more meaning. But as long as we understand it, the Baddha Avastha, whatever is the size, there will be dosha. I'll read more into this a little later. I didn't think of looking into the Bhashya more, but I'll see if I can find something more in the Bhashya, hidden in the Bhashya, and I'll make a correction if need be, if I understand more. So right now, whatever is the size in the Adya and Madhyama, so Parimana, so it can be a smaller and middle size, and another way you can read is in Moksha there will be an infinite size. So I tried to explain in multiple ways, whichever, you know, makes more sense or that you can agree with, hold on to that. Thereby Avishesha, between these three sizes there will be Avishesha, because you have said that the size is Nitya. If the Atma size is Nitya in Moksha Avastha, it will be Nitya in the earlier stages also. Thereby Avishesha Samyam Syat. Avishesha means no difference. No difference is Samyam. There will be similarity in Nityatvam for all of these three kinds of Deha Parimanas. Ataha Saugata Mata Vat. Like the Saugata Mata or the Bauddha Mata, Arhata Matam Api Apramanikam Iti Siddham. And thereby the Arhata Mata, Jaina Mata, is also Apramanikam, it is not Pramana Moola, it is Bhranti Moola. This is the conclusion. Purvam Sattva Asattvayor Ekatra Virodha Asambhava Ityuktam. The Purvapakshi, a different Purvapakshi, says, how did you refute the Jaina Paksha? You said that this Sattva and Asattva, Syadasti, Syannasti, Syadasti, Nasti, all these are opposing qualities simultaneously claimed by the Jaina in all Padarthas, Yugapat. So these Sattva and Asattva Dharmas cannot be Ekatra, cannot be there all at once. Therefore, there is a Virodha, Virodhat, and due to Virodha, Asambhava Ityuktam. There is an impossibility of these Virodhi Dharmas being together, Sattva and Asattva being together because of Virodha. Tarhi, then Tadvat, similarly what? Upadanatva kartrutvayor ekatra virodhat asambhavaha iti drishtanta sangatya idamaha. Now this upadanatva and kartrutva. Purvapakshi says upadanatva, your Brahma is upadana, upadana karana, and your Brahma is what? Karta also, jagat karta, nimitta karana also. This parabrahma being upadana and karta is Virodha. They are Virodhi Dharmas as per the Purvapakshi. Kulala is not Mrit, Mrit is not Kulala. Mrit is sentient, Mrit is insentient and Kulala is sentient. So there are Virodhi Dharma there also. So taking those Virodhi Dharmas into account, how can you say that sentient and insentient, sentient efficient cause, Nimitta Karana, and insentient material cause, Upadana Karana, can be together in this Paramatma, Parabrahma? How can you claim such a thing? There is Virodha. Therefore, Virodhat Asambhavaha. What is Asambhavaha? Upadanatva and Kartrutva being together in Parabrahma. Iti Drishtanta Sangatya Damaha. The sutra, so thereby Patyadhikaranam comes up. So Patyadhikaranam, the first sutra is, Pati is Jagat. Jagadadhipati in the Maheshwara Siddhanta, the Shaiva Siddhanta, Maheshwara Siddhanta, they say that this Adhipati, Pati, or Pati is Ishwara, Ishwara is Maheshwara, they claim this. So Patyurasamanjasyat is the first sutra there. So here Patyuhu Asamanjasyat, this Asamanjasyat Hetu, thereby Patyu is Patihi. Patihi Shashti, Panchami Ekvachana, Shashti Ekvachana, both you will get Patyuhu. So, in the Shashti, Patyuhu, meaning Patihi is Jagadadhipati, Jagatpati or Ishwara. So, Patyu is Ishwarasya. What is that? Jagad Upadana, he is not Jagad Upadana. They say that Ishwara is what? He will क्रिएट सो ही इज निमित्त कारण बीइंग निमित्त कारण सम मटेरियल इज देयर विच इज सेपरेट फ्रॉम हिम प्रधानादि वॉट एवर इज ए प्रधान प्रकृति सो ऑल दिस प्रधानादि प्रकृति प्रेरक इज ईश्वर ईश्वर विल गिव प्रेरणा एंड देयर बाय the insentient material will come together and prapancha will be created. Who is the creator? Ishvara. Maheshwara is the creator. So this Maheshwara, who is the pati, jagat adhipati, jagat pati, that Ishvara being nimitta karana will give prerana to the pradhanadi, as the sankhyas talk about prakriti, insentient, to come together and there be srishti. So there is some samya if you look at it from the Sankhya perspective, but there is also difference. In the Maheshwara Siddhanta as opposed to Sankhya's, this Purusha Ishwara is a Preraka. In the Sankhya's, Purusha is not Preraka, Purusha is Udasina. Purusha remains separate, he has nothing to do with the Pradhana creating the prapancha on its own. That we have already refuted. Now, the Maheshwara Siddhanti or Maheshwara Darshanika says that Ishwara Purusha is Preraka for Pradhanadi creation. He is not the material, so we don't have that dosha of Upadana and Nimitta Karana being one Maheshwara, but Maheshwara is Nimitta Karana, is a Preraka for the insentient Pradhanadi to create, come together. But you have this Virodha because you have a Abhinna Nimitta Upadana Karana, you the Siddhanti Vedanti. Now the refutation is Patyu Ishwarasya Jagad Upadana Karana Prerakatvena. What happens? Jagan Nimitta Matratvam Na Sambhavati. Asamanjasyat. Asamanjasyat is a hetu. Why? Because the we'll see the meaning in the vritti. There will be repetition. I'll just mention that one who is giving prerana for others to act, or just look at Kulala example itself. Kulala. So Kulala Adivacha. So Kulala is the example who is Nimitta Karana. The pot maker, the potter is the Nimitta Karana for the clay or the parts of the pot to come together. If there are kapalas, two kapalas are created and he brings them together, or he brings the water and water which is insentient material, upadana sahakari karana. So upadana need not be only upadana, sahakari karana. So he is the one who makes everything come together. He makes the chakra and the mrut come together. He makes the water and the mud come together. So he is a preraka. He is not himself the material, but he makes these material components to come together. Similarly, Ishvara brings about these. Now, Siddhanti says Asamanjasya is the dosha there. What is the dosha? Because if there is prerana from Ishvara for the Pradhana to be brought to, Pradhanadi to be brought together and create something, then when Kulala is creating, does he have something in the mind that I'll make this kind of a pot? When he makes multiple pots, does he decide same size or different sizes? Does he make something for someone as larger pot, smaller pot? And let's say if he has likes and dislikes towards some people, if there's a fight between him and the customer says that, oh, I want this tomorrow. The other, he's already working on something, and then the other person, he says, no, I'll not pay you, or whatever, you know, there is some, tussle there. This is all possible when you see the Nimitta Karana bringing together material in such a manner. The material is different, so he can have, he can put less things together, he can put more things together. In real creation, when he is creating something, he can have Raga Dvesha as biasing. Because you don't see anyone using material, using little, giving more, whatever. Even, children fight among themselves. We have seen earlier children fight among themselves saying that parents are doing partiality. Imagine mother doing partiality towards her sons, her children, sons and daughters. This is what is the perspective of the children. Mother may or may not be doing partiality. But we see, you know, we see that whatever is the thinking of the parent, we may not be able to understand. But still, the child, the especially the first child feels that the second child is pampered. In Vyakarana, we see the example given is when you start adding upasargas, in which order are the upasargas added? So, dhatu is considered as the mother. So, the first upasarga is added immediately before the dhatu, meaning the first child is in the arms of the mother. And then when the second child is born, the first child goes away, the second child takes the place of the first child, he is in the arms of the mother, and the first child is ill, is separated out a little, he is no longer in the arms. Similarly, the second upasarga which is added, that second upasarga will be added immediately before the dhatu, but there is already an upasarga, so that upasarga has to be separated and the second upasarga is added immediately before the dhatu. So, first upasarga will be separated out. Similarly with the pratyas also. Pratyas are added immediately after the dhatu. So, this is an example given by Vyakaranas as to how these upasargas are treated. They are treated like children. The sequence in which they are added, the earlier goes away from the dhatu, the mother. So, similarly here, now there can be an objection, the earlier child, the elder child says that there is partiality towards the second child. So, whatever is given also, if there is less available food, then the second child gets more. This can be an akshepa from the earlier child also. Why I am bringing this is that this is asamanjasyam. If at all the material is separate and the Ishwara has a choice in creation as to prerana, to give prerana, then there can be all sorts of partialities based on raga, dvesha, ityadi. And thereby the separate Ishwara who is a preraka also should be seen as having such doshas that we have seen in the loka. Because this kalpana that you are doing, for that kalpana some drishtanta has to be there. In drishtanta you don't see any neutral vyavahara, we see even parents having these doshas in the perspective of the child. And it is also there. Logically, you cannot say that it is not there. You can give a reason as to why it is there. The mother is taking care of the younger one because the younger one needs more attention. That need can be the hetu, but it cannot take away the raga dvesha. The raga towards the second child will be more than the earlier child. That is a given from the mother's perspective. This is a natural behavior. But then that natural behavior itself is flawed from the angle of the earlier child. He or she feels unloved. Anyway, all this is psychology. But what we need to see is that these raga dveshas can be prodding the preraka, can be the basis for the preraka, and that drishtanta has no counter in the world. Therefore, the Ishwara will be flawed. That is the asamanjasya hetu. So, asamanjasyat. Now, we look at the vritti quickly. Phalam puruvat, so samanvaya siddhi asiddhi ityadi. Kevalam adishthata Ishwaraha jagatahana upadanam iti maheshwara radhantotra vishaya. So, kevalam adishthata Ishwara. The Ishwara is not the jagat upadana. This adishthata meaning keval adishthata is what? Adishthatru. The way you say adishthatru devata. The adishthapati, jagatpati. So one who is only the nimitta karana, adishthata, one who is controlling the entire prapancha, that kind of Ishwara, he is not the upadana also. So na jagatha upadanam na iti maheshwara radhanta, maheshwara radhanta is siddhanta. This is the maheshwara siddhanta darshana, which is the Vishaya here. So they say that Maheshwara is the Jagat Karana, but Nimitta Karana, he is Adishthata. That is the meaning of Ishwara. He is not the Upadana Karana, he is not the material cause. So Kim Pramana Mula, meaning Saha Siddhanta Radhanta, Maheshwara Radhanta, Kim Pramana Mula Pranti Mulova, इति संदे दिस इज वेरी सिमिलर टू द अर्लियर वंस सो आई विल स्किप दिस प्रमाण मूल इति पूर्वपक्ष ऑब्वियसली द पूर्वपक्षी इज गोइंग टू क्लेम महेश्वर दार्शनिक इज गोइंग टू क्लेम दैट इज प्रमाण मूल सिद्धांतस्तु Siddhanti has the onus on Siddhanti is to disprove the claim and show that Maheshwara Darshana is what Bhranti Mula and then only Vedanta alone will be Pramana Mula. It is for this purpose alone that the refutation and doshas in the Maheshwara Darshana is being shown. Patyur Ishwarasya Patyuhu Shashti Ekvachana Ishwarasya. This Pati is Jagat Pati is Ishwara, so Tasya Ishwarasya. जगद उपादान प्रधानादि प्रेरकत्वेन जगन निमित्तत्व जगन निमित्त मात्रत्व न संभवति सिंस ही इज प्रेरक ऑफ दि प्रधानादि इनसेंशियंट थिंग्स मटेरियल्स एज पर दि महेश्वर दर्शन देन ही कैन नॉट बी जगन निमित्त मात्र जगन निमित्त मात्रत्व न संभवति ही कैन नॉट बी ओनली निमित्त कारण Because he is a preraka. Why? Oh, let him be preraka. So what says the Purvapakshi? Maheshwara Darshanika. So to that the Siddhanti says, Kutaha, Kasmat Karana, why can't Shiva Maheshwara be only Nimitta Karana and remain a preraka for the Pradhanadi? Why? Asamanjasyat. Asamanjasyat, this is not possible because there is Asamanjasyam. There is asamanjasya as to what? Ishwarasya jagat sarjane pravruttau ragadi dosha prasangat. What is the asamanjasya there? It is not appropriate. It is not appropriate. Why? Because jagat sarjane, sarjane srishti, in the jagat srishti, where the Ishwara is nimitta karana, there this Ishwara has pravritti so jagat sarjane pravruttau ishwarasya raga adi dosha prasangat raga ityadi will be the resultant meaning see what is asamanjasyam sama you start from sama is consistency or equality similarity then Asamanjasyam is the bhava of not being, not having samatva. Samanjasyam. So, just trying to get the words together. Samatva is the meaning of samanja. Samanja, you have to read a ya there. Because we understand the meaning with the भाव प्रत्यय तस्य भावत्वतलो श्यं श्यंवा सो श्यं प्रत्यय इज देयर सो दिस सामंजस्य सामंजस्य सो आई एम नॉट सामंज्य सामंजस्य सो य श्यं प्रत्यय देयर इज सामंजस्य सामंजस्य श्यं प्रत्यय यू रिमूव दैट यू गेट सामंज समंजस समंजस दिस समंजस इज द बीइंग सिमिलर असामंजस इज not being similar so tasya bhava asamanjasyam meaning inconsistency that's what it means I was trying to get a good translation for asamanjasyam so asamanjasyam is inconsistency what is that inconsistency inconsistency is a flaw the ghatakara even if he tries to create pots manually of the same size and you know color everything there will be a shade of difference there will be some difference Now this difference can be due to raga dvesha or not, but then giving a larger pot to someone and smaller pot to someone else, you want as we have seen earlier also you try to look for, you know multiple products of the same size even if they are creating in on the shop floor there may be some difference that's why there is a QA we had seen this quality test QT and QA is all. Because of this reason that there can machines can also be flawed let alone human beings who have created machines or creating the products themselves handmade so there will definitely be an issue there by raga dvesha ityadi so asamanjasyam syat what is that pravruttihi ragaadi purvakatvena loke drushtatva because we have seen in the world that there is a pravruti only because of some raga adi somebody is doing something because of raga और द्वेष सो रागादि इमोशंस आर बैकिंग मनःपूर्वकत्वं कार्यस्य एनी कार्य दैट इज बीइंग डन देर इज सम थिंकिंग देर बुद्धिपूर्वकत्वं सो दैट बुद्धि इज क्लाउडेड विद दी अंतकरणाज रोल एज मनः वेर देर आर संस्काराज ऑफ रागादि रागद्वेष इत्यादि सो दे विल डेफिनेटली क्लाउड दी बुद्धि एंड दी हाउएवर न्यूट्रल ईश्वर वॉन्ट्स टू बी वॉट विल हैपन इज दैट लाइक दी ह्यूमन बीइंग्स ऑल्सो ही ऑल्सो हैव दोषास लाइक द ह्यूमन बीइंग्स ही ऑल्सो एंड अप हैविंग दोषास एंड दैट इज ए असामंजस्यम इनकन्सिस्टेंसी राग आदि पूर्वकत्व लोके दृष्टत्वात् ओके पूर्वपक्षी सेज यू हैव सीन इन द वर्ल्ड सो वॉट यू हैव नॉट सीन महेश्वरा इन द वर्ल्ड महेश्वरा मे बी विदाउट राग आदि Why do you read Ragadi doshas in Maheshwara? So then the Siddhanti says, Drishtanusarityat Kalpanayaha. This is a Kalpana. Your Darshana is a Kalpana where you are saying Ishwara is Nimitta Karana only and not Upadana Karana. So you have to give an example in the world where you have seen such a Nimitta Karana without Ragadi doshas. Who is influencing the material cause, Upadana Karana? सो दृष्ट दृष्टानुसारित्वात् वॉट हैव यू सीन इन दी लोके दृष्टत्वात् एंड लोके दृष्टानुसारित्वात् दी कल्पना शुड बी अनुसारी अनुसारिणी कल्पना बीइंग स्त्रीलिंग इट शुड बी दृष्टानुसारिणी इट शुड बी फॉलोइंग वॉट एवर इज सीन इन दी वर्ल्ड दैट काइंड ऑफ कल्पना यू कैन मेक यू कैन नॉट इमेजिन समथिंग दैट इज नॉट सीन इन दी वर्ल्ड सम पार्ट्स यू कैन पुट टुगेदर दैट वे बट देन कल्पना इज ऑलवेज फॉलोइंग वॉट एवर इज सीन अस्माकं तु देन If that dosha is then Purvapakshi can say, what about in your case? In your case also, if this Parabrahma can be with Ragadi doshas, why only my darshana are you showing this flaw? To that, say Siddhanti answers, Asmakam tu. Asmakam, in our case, we do not have such flaws of Ragadi dosha in Parabrahma. Why? Asmakam tu shrutyanusaritvad anirvachaniya vaditvachana dosha iti bhavaha. Because we follow Shruti. Ours is Vedanta. Anta is nischaya there. Whatever is the statement in the Shruti, we are in line with that. So if you show flaws, then you will become Nastika. Because we are establishing, we have already done that in the first Adhyaya. We have shown Samanvaya of all Vedavakyas in Parabrahma as the Abhinna Nimitta Upadana Karana. And not only that, we are also what? Anirvachaniya Vadi. Since we are Anirvachana Vadis, meaning the Srishti that you see is with Ragadi Doshas, those Ragadi Doshas are also not real. They are Mithya. Srishti is also Mithya. So Mithya Srishti with Mithya Ragadi Doshas is not Dosha at all. For us, this is a Mithya Srishti, therefore there is no real Ragadi Doshas at all. Shrutyanusarityat and what is the Shrutyanusari there? Bhagavan is creating based on the karma of the jivas. And what is that creation? It is an appearance. Therefore, we don't have such doshas at all. Apicha, sambandhanupapatteshcha. I'll take this sutra as well. Apicha, also what? Sambandhanupapatteshcha. Sambandhanupapattehe cha. संबंधस्य अनुपपत्तिः तस्याः हेतोः च नाउ इफ यू से ईश्वर इज निमित्त कारण एंड प्रधानादि आर उपादान कारण ईश्वर इज प्रेरक देन व्हाट इज द संबंध बिटवीन ईश्वर एंड द प्रधानादि कारण उपादान कारण सो निमित्त कारण ईश्वर एंड प्रधानादि उपादान कारण व्हाट इज द कनेक्शन बिटवीन देन सम संबंध हैज टू बी मेंशनड Now, which is the sambandha? Is it samavaya sambandha or sanyoga sambandha? What is the sambandha? To that, whatever the darshanika, Maheshwara darshanika answers, that will not hold good. Sambandha itself is not possible. Between Ishwara and Pradhanadi sambandha, no kind of sambandha is possible. Samavaya is not possible, sanyoga is also not possible. I'll explain the vritti in the next sutra, but we'll cover the sutra itself. So, why is there sambandha anupapatti? What if you say there is a Sanyoga Sambandha? Sanyoga Sambandha is not possible. Sanyoga is between those which are Bhinna. To this, the Darshanika will say, oh, Ishvara is Bhinna, Nimitta Karana Pradhanadi are, Nimitta Karana Ishvara is Bhinna from Upadana Karana Pradhanadi. So, Sanyoga Sambandha Hotu. To that, the Siddhanti says, Sanyoga Sambandha, although it is between Bhinna Padarthas, still it is not between limited and limitless, or Savayava and Niravayava. Ishvara is Niravayava. Maheshwara, is he having parts or not having parts? Maheshwara is a name given to Ishvara. In the Puranas, there may be description as to how he looks. That is Saguna Ishvara. But then, that is all for Dhyana Ityadi. Puja Dhyana Ityadi. There is no, or for Murti creation, etc. But you do not really consider Ishvara as having form. Ishvara is formless. He does not have parts. So that Ishvara who is partless cannot have Sambandha with Pradhana which has parts. We have seen this earlier. Like Hasta Pustaka Sanyoga also. When you see Sanyoga Sambandha between Hasta Pustaka, hand and a book, a part of the hand is touching the part of the book. The entire book is not touching the part of the hand. The entire hand is not touching the part of the book. And even the third possibility of entire hand touching the entire pustaka is also not possible. So, Sanyoga is between two entities which have parts, and there is Sanyoga between their parts, between the parts of the two entities. Never is there a Sanyoga possible between the whole and the part of the other, or whole and the whole of the other. It's not possible. So, Ishvara who is partless, the whole, cannot have Sambandha with someone which is having parts, with something, Pradhanadi which is having parts. So, Sanyoga Sambandha is not possible. Then the Purva Pakshi can claim, Samavaya Sambandha astu. Why not have Samavaya Sambandha? Samavaya Sambandha which is between Kriya Kriyavan, Guna Guni, Ityadi, that kind of a Samavaya Sambandha is not possible. Why? Samavaya Sambandha is possible between two which are one is inseparable. They are inseparable there. Guna and Guni are inseparable. This is the Siddhanti. Tarkika will not say so. Tarkika reads them differently. But even in the Tarkika, Samavaya, what is the Samavaya between? Samavaya Sambandha is possible only between those which are what? In the Karya Karana also you see between the thread and the cloth. So if you see it like the thread and the cloth, there is Samavaya Sambandha. See, between the threads of one cloth and the same cloth. So let's say we'll take an example, red and blue. So let's say there is a red cloth and a blue cloth, only to make a differentiation. There is no color needed here, but to show that the clothes are different. So now, what is the Sambandha between? Sambandha is between the red threads and the red cloth. That is Samavaya Sambandha. Between the red threads and the blue cloth, or the blue threads and the red cloth, there is no Sambandha. Meaning what? There cannot be Samavaya Sambandha between threads of one cloth and the other cloth. With the same cloth, there should be Sambandha. So what is it? What does it mean? Having claimed that Ishvara is Nimitta Karana who is separate from the Pradhanadi Upadana Karana, they are Bhinna. So Ishvara is Bhinna as Nimitta Karana, and Pradhanadi are Bhinna from Ishvara as Upadana Karana. So there is a difference. So they are like red and blue cloth. Red and blue clothes. So the red and blue clothes cannot have Samavaya Sambandha between each other. You cannot say the red cloth and blue cloth have Samavaya Sambandha, nor can you say that the red thread or the blue thread has a Sambandha with the blue cloth and the red cloth in Samavaya respectively. What is a Samavaya Sambandha? Between the red threads and the red cloth, or the blue threads and the blue cloth, there is no other Samavaya Sambandha possible. So therefore also Samavaya Sambandha is not possible between those who do not have a part and whole relationship at all. So, where is the Samavaya Sambandha possible? So neither is the Sanyoga Sambandha possible nor the Samavaya Sambandha. So Sambandha Anupapattescha, what? There cannot be Ishvara being a Preraka Nimitta Karana to the Pradhanadi separate Upadana Karana. Therefore the Maheshwara Darshana which claims this, that is invalid. We will see the Vritti tomorrow. The reason is because there is some word which has to be explained, and that I'll explain in the next part, whenever it is. Amnayante samsiddham adhimadhyanta varjitam anandaghanam apurnam atma jyotir upasmahe. Namaste, dhanyavada.
Namaste, thank you.